We are trying to recover some of the most important ecosystems on Earth. The future is problematic. We are swimming against the current.
Los corales que antes habían corales grandes, hermosos, y había muchos peces alrededor. Y ahí uno buceaba y encontraba langosta, porque el coral llama a los peces. Pero ahora como casi hay, el coral está tan malo, los peces grandes ya salen como más afuera. Así que he visto la diferencia total.
I'm Laura Quiñones, a journalist with the United Nations, and I've just come back from the Colombian island of San Andrés. The coral reefs are breathtaking, but they are in danger. Mass tourism, pollution, and climate change have led to a worrying decline in live coral cover.
Uno sabe ya que si no hay coral, no hay peces. Y si no hay peces, no puedo sostener a mi familia igual.
The Seaflower Biosphere Reserve is very special. It is actually 10% of the Caribbean. And the community, the Reefs people that has been living here for generations, they learned how to relate to these ecosystems in a healthy and sustainable way for many, many years. And this is the way of living of not only the Reefs people, but the resident people as well. So we depend completely on these ecosystems and on its biodiversity.
Hola, nene. Ya cambió de rojo a amarillo y ya permitieron el buceo, ya abrieron el buceo.
The ecosystems have gotten to a point where they need a helping hand. So if the local organizations, the local heroes don't act, they will continue to degrade until they are no longer functional.
I decided to take a dive with the women-led NGO Blue Indigo to see how they are restoring and protecting marine ecosystems.
Las comunidades mismas somos las que estamos desarrollando y recuperando nuestros propios ecosistemas.
Local fishermen, biologists, and divers join forces to create community awareness and restore coral reefs.
Yo pensaba eso. Ay, un coral se está poniendo viejo ya y se le está saliendo canas. Pero yo no sabía que era por el clima, todo lo que está pasando en el mundo.
Son especies pioneras con las que trabajamos que le ayudan al arrecife a recuperarse por sí mismo y atraen sobre todo los juveniles de los peces de importancia económica y ecológica.
Y últimamente se ha visto la diferencia que han crecido. Donde había mucho daño que no hay coral, ya sembramos y ya se está viendo que se está poniendo hermoso. Yo estoy orgulloso de eso, yo me siento como un superhéroe. Sí.
Blue Indigo also teams up with diving schools, teaching international visitors about coral restoration.
When people come over to see our project, they get engaged easier because then they ask you, my coral that we planted on the reef, how it's doing. So we are seeing that the more physically involved that you get, the easier it is for you to be aware of the problem.
These activities give real meaning to the UN Decade on Ecosystem Restoration.
What we need is a functional ecosystem. So we are trying to at least give it a helping hand so it can adapt to climate change, because the ecosystem is going to change. That is going to happen. But at least it can change in a way that is not going to die completely.
Si no hay coral, ya casi no hay vida. Y sin vida, todos perdemos. Mm-hmm. Yeah, man.